raising its outlook for from $85 a barrel to $87 a barrel in its short-term energy outlook today. The higher outlook comes as oil prices staged a rally recently. Sears updating its wish book experience to the social media age. The iconic book now available at Sears.com, but it's also got a Facebook version where users can share their lists and an app phone. Make that an app for the iPhone and the iPad. Sears says it will still carry the tried and true paper catalogs. Joan Jones, Dow Jones Money Report.
Why do we rely on just investing when there's another way? A way to measure success over a lifetime, not just a single day. Where you don't chase what's hot, you do what's right. And where there's one rule, the golden rule. We call it vanguarding. Vanguarding is a behavior, a philosophy, a call to action. So ask yourself, are you just investing or are you vanguarding? Learn more at Vanguard.com or call us at 888-VANGUARD. All investments are subject to risk.
Ford and Lincoln Mercury Service presents Mike Rowe talking about getting to work.
No, nope, that's wrong.
Why don't you just tell us what you're talking about then?
I'm talking about getting the works at a Ford or Lincoln Mercury dealership.
Ah, the works is an oil change, tire rotation, multi-point inspection, and more. Just $29.95 or less after $10 rebate.
See, now you're talking about the works.
Well, with the works, there's a lot to talk about.
Visit your Ford or Lincoln Mercury dealer and see if the works works for you.
Up to 5 quarts oil pack. Diesel and disposal fees extra. See participating dealership or visit genuineservice.com for rebate details through 11/30/10.
AutoTrader.com introduces the Trade-In Marketplace, where you can get a fair offer on a car you want to trade in or sell. Just visit tradein.autotrader.com today.
Good afternoon. Mike Raley, North Carolina News Network Sports. Carolina Panthers quarterback Matt Moore is out for the rest of the season with a torn labrum in his throwing shoulder. Coach John Fox wouldn't say if Jimmy Clausen or fellow rookie Tony Pike would start Sunday in Tampa Bay. Pike played some in the fourth quarter of the Saints game and had some good moments on the field.
For me in general, just kind of a lift for me to time you're an NFL player or a player in general and you see some good things happen, your confidence is going to grow a little bit. So to be able to do that and move the ball a little bit, you know, it obviously felt good.
The NFL is lost in the Supreme Court, correspondent Jack Briggs reports.
The Supreme Court won't stop a Minnesota state court from getting involved in a fight between the NFL and Minnesota players Kevin Williams and Pat Williams over violations of the league's anti-doping policy. The High Court refused Monday to hear an appeal from the NFL. The players took a weight loss supplement, which contained an unlisted but banned diuretic that can mask the presence of steroids. The federal courts threw out the players' appeal over their suspensions, but said there were issues that should be considered in state court.
North Carolina State kicker Josh Joukowsky is going to miss at least the rest of the regular season with a hamstring injury. Coach Tom O'Brien says his kicker was hurt in the fourth quarter of Saturday's loss at Clemson. You're listening to the North Carolina News Network.
We'll be sunny and within shouting distance of 70 this afternoon, then clear tonight, not quite so cool. We'll be down into the low 40s. Tomorrow back to sunshine, our middle of the week highs in the mid to upper 60s. I'm meteorologist Randy Jackson on FM Talk 101.1 WZTK.
It's good to have you back. Coming up later, Jesse Dupree of Jackal, and we will be taking your calls. Right now, John Stossel has always picked one of those subjects that someone's going to disagree with, and he says there is reverse racism. At least they're going to be discussing it on Stossel and the Fox Business Channel this Thursday night, 9 o'clock Eastern. So what do you think? 866-482-1011. 866-482-1011. The other topic is political correctness going crazy. You can also reach me on Twitter. Just look for Alan Handelman or If It Rocks. And we're set. All right, 866-482-1011. As we go to New York, it's line four. It is Jonathan. What do you think, Jonathan? Good to have you on.
Hey, a lot of times people and we go with who we're familiar with, and sometimes these minorities may never be picked because someone has already picked someone that they're familiar with, you know, including race. You know, it may be someone, you know, that they play golf with, and if you're not out there playing golf or if you're not in the right social settings, you may never, ever get picked. And then you think athletes are dominantly African-American. sometimes some people need a help to make it diverse. It's almost being forced to a degree.
Yeah, that's an interesting point. I guess in a lot of ways, athletes, if they're going by ability, black athletes excel over white athletes. Is that an unfair statement to make?
Well, you can say that, but what I was just saying is, like, really the military is there's a lot of African-American. They need more of an opportunity, I should say, and they might go into the military, but you may not see majority of the command looking as if the ranks. They may